If you're watching this series, please help us pay for it. We can't go on without your help. This special weekend of tomorrow, like all weekends, will be almost over before it's begun. That's why there is no time to put off your call. And if you haven't given to the life support system of this station, you're threatening its future. Federal funding cutbacks and inflation make it imperative that the station turn to the public for a larger percent of its funding support than ever before. And when you think about it, that's only fair. After all, we who watch 13 are the people who benefit from it the most. While the station works hard to recruit other sources of funding, it needs to be assured of its public support. The support from viewers must grow by 1985 from the present level of over 25% to 50%. The days of almost 9 out of 10 viewers taking 13 for granted must end. And this weekend, with your help, can really brighten 13's tomorrows. Ireland, a television history, is the first full history of Ireland, all 8,000 complex years of it ever produced. You don't have to be Irish to love it. Though, of course, those viewers who share an Irish heritage are finding this series a particularly rewarding experience. This tri-state community boasts a great number of them indeed. I find it rather moving that many of you who will call during this break are the descendants of the people we all learned so much about tonight. Tonight's viewing community also finds its roots in County Galway, County Mayo, County Carlow, County Cork, County Kilkenny, and County Limerick. And there's only one way to let 13 know that they did the right thing in presenting this series. That's by calling now and saying so with a pledge of support. Every single dollar you give gives you rewards you can see right here. 13 is not asking you for charity. It's asking you for sustenance to keep this station evergreen. Is a series like Ireland worth to you? Only you can decide. A basic membership pledge is $35, which entitles you to the superb Dial magazine and program guide. Now, don't dismiss the Dial as just another guide. It's as special as this station. But please, make your call now. Become a $35 member or pledge whatever amount you can afford. This weekend is giving you a straightforward chance to preserve the greatest premium 13 can offer. This program. In a moment, this station presents Broadway Plays Washington, the stars, the showstoppers, and the songs that have made Broadway the source of so much of America's great music. Every call helps 13, but every call during this break is a particular tribute to Ireland, a television history. And I want that tribute to be an outstanding one worthy of this series. Now let's join Donna Drews now and see how we've started off the evening.
Thank you, John. You started off pretty well. You can hear the phones in the background, but we want those numbers to get even higher. We have 91 calls so far. And we have $3,826. It's up to you to get that total way up there by the end of this weekend of tomorrow. We just want to remind you that this weekend of tomorrow all depends on you. Thousands of people, lots of man hours, lots of energy have gone into making this a spectacular weekend, and it all culminates Monday night with the world premiere of the movie of tomorrow, Annie, at our own Radio City Music Hall. And all the benefits from this premiere go to Channel 13, as John's told you, thanks to the generosity of the producers. And we think this whole idea should spur you to action. We need your generosity. We need your support because you're the public in public television, and that's more than just a catchword. It's the truth. So those 91 calls at $3,826, we hope those phones ring off the hook and we can give you really big numbers next time. We're not setting a goal this weekend. It's up to you to set the pace. Whatever amount you can afford to give, whether it's $5, $500, whatever. But we do have a little incentive for you. For the two highest pledges of this weekend, we have this, a shooting script from the film of Annie, and it's autographed by all the stars. Little Aileen Quinn, she says Aileen Annie Quinn up here, and right above that is Daddy Warbucks himself, Albert Finney, Carol Burnett, and Tim Curry. All the stars from the show have autographed this. We have two of these, and these will be yours if you give one of the two highest pledges for this weekend. This is a good incentive, but of course the programs are the real incentive, so what about it? Let's get these phones ringing. And now John has a little more for you.
It's true that any amount is being stressed tonight, but don't underestimate what you are protecting when you pledge $35 or more to become a member of the station. New cable systems are raining like confetti, and there isn't one that suggests that you can enjoy their programs for a full year for $35. And what is more disappointing, there isn't one that promises to deliver the variety, the scope, the day-in, day-out quality that you're getting right now on Easy Accessible 13. It's your voluntary support that keeps the programs here uninterrupted. It's your voluntary support that means 13 does not send you a monthly bill. And a lot of you who are watching this station in record-breaking numbers are not volunteering any dollars to the station. And that neglect can do more damage than any federal funding cutback or inflation. I know there are far more people who are grateful for this series in Ireland than there are phones here tonight. Silence will not pay the bill. There are some silent phones, so let's hear them ring. If you can afford to become a $35 member, become one tonight. You'll be guaranteeing those day-in, day-out, every night a week variety of services that only 13 offers. From Hallmark children's programs to outstanding news analysis, from local programs to international drama, opera, ballet, and documentary series like Ireland, A Television History. All of us who enjoy the station have a stake in its future. It's our station. The 13, the decade of the 80s, emphasizes the community. It has great plans for programs that stress our common responsibility with shows dedicated to defining our past and helping us to decide the future. New series are planned to continue our common search for knowledge in the tradition of cosmos and life on Earth. In the realm of our common imagination, 13 will continue to excel in series based on art and pleasure. And our common values, our love of freedom and opportunity, will be developed by new series along the lines of Bill Moyer's Journal and our In Pursuit of Liberty series. Well, tonight, if all of you who share my pleasure in this great series on Ireland can make a financial commitment to this station, our great community will continue to share the uncommon experience of this exceptional programming. Use these last seconds to make note of the number. Be counted for Ireland and 13. Thank you.
The phones are pretty busy. I guess there are a lot of Ireland fans out there. A lot of the Irish and the Irish loving, and people who just want to know a little bit more about their world. You're calling in, but we still have a few phones that aren't ringing, so if you've been meaning to call, if you're one of the people who, when they find out I work for Channel 13, says, gee, I love your programming, and I say, have you pledged, and they say, not yet. If you're one of those people, not yet is right now, okay? So call. You know, we're part of a noble experiment now. Public television has always been a noble experiment, but it's getting a little nobler and a little scarier because the federal government has withdrawn a lot of funding. That means the public has to take up the slack. So if you're one of those who depend on public television for quality programming, if you're one of the ones who's been getting a free ride up to now, the buck stops here, folks. There's no more free ride. Public television needs your support. That's you. Okay?
Another way to help 13 during this special weekend of tomorrow is simply mail a check. But please, use this special address. It's 13 Box 1313A, New York 10101. And be sure to put the letter A following Box 1313. Thank you. The weekend of tomorrow, three special days to build many special tomorrows on your 13.
Thank you. Major funding for Kennedy Center tonight was provided by the Shell Companies Foundation, supporting the arts, education, and other charities. Additional funding was provided by the Program Fund of the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by this and other public television stations.
Before Broadway continues, our three-day weekend of tomorrow is just getting started live in the 13 studio. This is a crucial weekend built on the energies of thousands of tri-state area people, all for the financial benefit of your 13. And we need each and every one of you to join them. Now here to tell you about this weekend of firsts is the actor you enjoy from Ryan's Hope. You can hear him sing tonight through May 22nd at O'Neill's in Times Square. You'll go there right from our studio, and we're glad John Gabriel is here now for 13.
Good evening. Broadway may be playing Washington tonight, but it really belongs to New York. And 13's bringing it home right now to our own community. I think all of us in the tri-state area have a sense of personal pride when we hear a world-famous song from a Broadway show and know it started right here in our own backyard. The Broadway musical is certainly one of our community's greatest assets. I volunteered to be here tonight to convince you to help another one of this community's greatest assets. The place you're watching and enjoying right now, our own public television station, 13. Do you realize this local treasure has been running 20 years? Now that's a long-running hit, but unlike a Broadway show, 13 is not supported by out-of-town ticket buyers. It's you and I, the people who live in this community, who will decide just how long 13 continues its run. That decision is made by calling the number on your screen and making a pledge of support in any amount. When I say 13's tomorrow is in your hands, it's not a slogan, it's a fact. More true now than ever before. The cutbacks in federal funding supports are a challenge for active and imaginative community participation and volunteerism. Producer Ray Stark has met that challenge by dedicating the national premieres of Annie to public television. The first and biggest of these premieres will be held this Monday night at 8 at Radio City Music Hall, and it's entirely for the benefit of Channel 13, and it's filled with an audience of 13 supporters. It's that spirit of support 13 needs from every one of us today, tomorrow and Monday, as it is celebrated this three-day weekend of tomorrow. This special weekend concludes when 13 presents Annie's debut Monday night at 8 o'clock, an exciting special celebrating the Hollywood-style world premiere of the movie of tomorrow, Annie. This weekend, we're urging you to pledge whatever you can, 5, 10, 15, 20, 100, 500, or $1,000 to ensure the continuation of the greatest bonus 13 has ever offered all of us. It's superb programs. Every silent phone hurts 13's future, so please, pick up your phone, dial the number on your screen, and speak up for 13 now. Make it even easier, and use any major credit card to make your pledge. All of us who live in this community and enjoy the station have a part to play this weekend. Won't you join the cast now?
What it because of its enduring way of trying to help the public in general without expanding on profits or things that really don't concern small children or parents, really.
I support Channel 13 because it's something that I want to do for my family. And I find that they give me something that I could not do at home for them.
We're a Channel 13 family, I suppose. I think Nova's pretty good and all the specials.
I support Channel 13 because it's good for the children. It's a good clean, it's cultural. It's open-minded.
Well, I support Channel 13 because I think it's just the best station on television. I really do.
If there was no public station, then he wouldn't be watching any TV. And we'd be very angry and very upset.
And television has been a wasteland except for Channel 13.
Those are just a few of the people who do more than say kind words for 13. They help pay the bills here. And every year, your community support is needed more than ever. 13's tomorrows are seriously affected by inflation and federal funding cutbacks. Last year, the community shouldered 25% of the station's budget. This year, we'll need to meet 33% of the job. And as you can see, by 1985, 50% of the budget will be our responsibility. That's as it should be when you think about it. After all, we're the public in public television. And 13 is our station. It would be great to hear those phones ring with pledges of $35 or more. And of course, everyone who makes such a pledge becomes a member of 13 and will receive every single month for a year the Dial program guide and magazine, from its background articles on the shows to its crossword puzzles. It's as good a read as 13 is a view. But don't say, I can't afford the membership fee and not call. If you can afford any amount, for instance, the price of the movie tonight that you saved by watching 13, that's fine. Because the number on your screen, here it is. And here's Donna Drews to show you how we're doing.
John, we must have a lot of people out there who love the program Ireland, because we got 358 calls. Well, actually, we have now 358 altogether. And it was over 250 calls last time, so thank you. We now have $12,417 in our coffers, but our phones are really dead now. So if you were trying to get in the last break and you've given up, don't do it. We can't afford to let you give up. This three-day weekend of fundraising is an experiment. We want to see how much money we can raise in this short period rather than an extended period. But you set the pace. We have no goal. It's up to you to call in and give us your support and let us know how many of you. Thank you. There's one person. What about the rest of you? You know, that one fella said, I'd be very angry and upset if there was no such thing as public television. And he's a nice fella. Let's not let him down. Let's not let down all the other people who are members of 13, who are shouldering the burden. All of you who are out there sitting, oh, gee, I wish the program would come on. Well, it will. If you support us, it'll keep coming on day in and day out. If you support public television, you know, with the cutback in federal funding, this experiment is more than just a haphazard experiment. It's a necessity. We have to have more public support. So for the 9 out of 10 of you out there who have not called in and pledged your support, now's the time. Don't let the other guys shoulder the burden. It's time for you to do it. John?
You still have time to make your pledge, but if you're in one of those areas that have overloaded circuits, please make note of the phone number and keep trying. I couldn't help but think when Debbie Reynolds sang, I Ain't Down Yet, from the unsinkable Molly Brown, how that captures the spirit of this station. In a time of great financial crisis, 13 is completing what many people consider its finest season ever. Since January, 6 new series bowed on 13 that are hallmarks in their genre. For music, it was Leonard Bernstein conducting the 9 Beethoven symphonies. For history, the continuing series in the history of Ireland, which many of you enjoy tonight at 8. There was Bill Moyer's series on creativity, the new American Playhouse drama series, the unequaled nature series Life on Earth, and of course, the magnificent drama Brideshead Revisited. And by the way, don't miss tomorrow night when Anthony Andrews, Jeremy Irons, and Diana Quick have a few words to say on behalf of 13. How many of these series did you watch and enjoy? Isn't it time you made your call and pledged something to 13? Your pledge is not charity, even though it's tax deductible to the fullest extent of the law. Your pledge is 13's sustenance, and it needs it to make tomorrow happen. It's how your station does the job. I'm here, the volunteers are here, the crews and production team, we're all here waiting to stand side by side with you.
What would we do without you? Ooh, how would we ever get through? Ooh, who sends anniversary wishes? Who helps with the dishes and never says boo? Who changes subjects on cue? Who cheers us up when we're blue? Who is a flirt but never a threat? Reminds us of our friendlies, which we always forget.
Stop.
Coming right up in the next act, side by side, is a lineup of Broadway talent and songs with John Cullum, Bobby Morse, Larry Kurt, John Raitt, and Cheetah Rivera, soaring through some of the greatest showstoppers in Broadway's history. We stop the show to hear from you tonight. So I really hope your pledge for another 13 will come through tonight. That's the only way we're going to make count 13's tomorrows. Thank you.
Remember, you can pledge any amount, $5, $10, $50, but the two highest pledges for this three-day weekend of tomorrow will receive the shooting script of Annie, the film Annie, which debuts Monday night from Radio City Music Hall. It has all the autographs of all the stars on it, and it's for you if you give us the highest pledge. The two top pledges will get one of these shooting scripts. Our basic membership is $35, but we need to hear from all of you. You set the pace on this weekend. You let us know you're out there. We need you, and that's no joke. Call us.
If you prefer, send a check to 13, Box 1313A, New York 10101. That's 13, Box 1313A, New York 10101. And thank you. Day one of 3 days that will decide many tomorrows for 13. Make it count and be counted tonight.
It's a special three-day weekend here at 13, and tonight's the first night. It's a weekend filled with the energies of thousands of people and glittering stars all doing their part to support 13. This is a benefit weekend for 13. If you're a member of our viewing community, now's the time to join in. After all, we all benefit from 13. Right now, live in our studio is one of 13's most generous friends. He's just toured the Orient, but Darren McGavin hasn't forgotten his community and 13. Come join him now.
Oh, Cheetah, that was some act. And I can tell you that there are a lot more show-stopping numbers ahead in Broadway Plays Washington. Many of them with the original performers who made the moments for the Broadway history books. But do you know what's the biggest show-stopping number you'll ever see on this station? It's that number at the bottom of your screen. No joke. Ignore that number, and everything you enjoy on 13 will stop cold. That's why 13 has stopped the show first, to give you the chance to call and pledge any amount you choose to help keep the station going. And the key words are any amount. Let's make those phones light up over there with the kind of energy Cheetah Rivera just gave us. This is the first day of 13's three-day weekend. It ends Monday night with the benefit world premiere performance of Annie, the movie of tomorrow. The benefit is a generous gift to this station and our community. You'll see the premiere excitement when 13 presents Annie's debut this Monday at 8. Here, take a peek. Look, take a look.
She always was everyone's favorite orphan, and now she's gone Hollywood. It's Annie's debut, and she's sharing it with us. Even as she's world premiering at Radio City, we'll be partying with the very stars who turned her into the biggest movie musical ever. How did they do it? You'll find out, and you'll even see some of Annie's magic. Chock full of surprises, you can bet your bottom dollar that Annie's debut is the event of tomorrow. We've been singing a lot about tomorrow ourselves lately, but with Annie's debut on 13, we'll all be singing together.
You can bet your bottom dollar. Right now, the station invites you to actively participate in this exciting event for 13 and make your pledge. If you can afford $35 or more, call and become a member of 13 and join the thousands who now, as members, not only look at 13, but look forward to the nifty program guide and magazine, The Dial. Did I hear you say that I can't afford $35 or more? Well, that's okay. That's fine. How much can you afford? I mean, what would you give to keep the station going? Has 13 been worth a movie or two to you this year? Well, the station can use that $5 or $10. In fact, to encourage you to give that movie money to 13, here's a very special treat for you. If you're already a member of 13, you probably saw in the May issue of the Dial a list of 20 movies. It's on page 31. 13 asked all members to choose four of the 20 titles by May 10th, and the winning four would be shown this summer on Cinema 13's Choice Film Festival. Well, they've extended the contest for tonight to give anyone who makes a pledge for any amount a chance to vote for their personal choice. So get out your pencil and write down the number next to your favorite four titles. You might also use this moment to get any major credit card handy so you can charge your pledge for any amount at the same time. So here's Donna Drew with the number of people who've helped us so far this important weekend and the list of film titles. Donna?
Darren, 626 people have called. We now have $16,902. That's not bad. Almost 300 of you called last time, so let's get these films, these phones going, but first the films. Now here's the list of the 20 films eligible for our Viewer's Choice 13 Film Festival. The top four will be shown, and the winners will be announced this Monday. 13 celebrates the world premiere of Hollywood's latest major release on any debut, Monday at 8. Your pencils ready? You comfortable? Now choose no more than four, okay? Just write down the number of the film. You can see Arthur Miller's All My Sons with Burt Lancaster and Edward G. Robinson. Or find out what those Hubbards were like before the Little Foxes and choose Lillian Hellman's Another Part of the Forest. Or there's Charles Boyer and Margaret Sullivan in the definitive version of Backstreet. And there's the big Ray Milland thriller, The Big Clock. Now, if being scared is your scene, choose Cape Fear. Robert Mitchum will do the rest. Ooh, it is scary. And there's Billy Wilder's post-war comedy with Marlena Dietrich, A Foreign Affair. Or you can see Gary Cooper and The General Died at Dawn. Now there's George Rath and Edward Arnold starring in Dashiell Hammett's The Glass Key. Or choose Preston Sturges' classic comedy, Hail a Conquering Hero. Or see Mae West conquer Cary Grant in I'm No Angel. That's the worst Mae West imitation I've ever heard. Okay. There's Ronald Coleman's shining performance in Rudyard Kipling's The Light That Failed. Or how about Shirley Temple and Little Miss Marker? Jeanette MacDonald and Marie Chevalier again, and music by Rodgers and Hart, star in Love Me Tonight. Or there's Ray Milland in Fritz Lang's Ministry of Fear, based on a Graham Greene story. Deanna Durbin is the minority in 100 Men and A Girl. And there's the comedy Our Hearts Were Young and Gay. Claudette Colbert stars in Preston Sturges' screwball comedy, The Palm Beach Story. Or you can vote for Tracy and Hepburn in The State of the Union. Rosalind Russell is the liberated lady in Take a Letter, Darling, or you can invite 13 to show you that haunting thriller, The Uninvited. Well, that's the list. And if you remember and didn't send in your choice, grab your copy of the Dial and let us know now with a little extra support. Give the numbers of your choices to the operator who takes your pledge. All viewers are invited to vote, but to do so, you must vote to give 13 some dollars to keep the shows and movies coming. That's the most important thing you can do for our tomorrows on this special three-day weekend. And now back to you, Derek.
Oh, boy, Donna, thank you. You're so right when you say that the most important choice you can make is to choose to help us with some dollars now. In a moment, you're going to see Elaine Stritch, dear Stritch, do her unforgettable number from Company, titled The Ladies Who Lunch. But first, how about a very sincere toast to 13 for bringing this night and so many others to you. This three-day weekend is a mighty short time to help do a very big job. Maybe you won't be with us tomorrow or Monday, and that means the next time you watch 13, this phone number won't be here. But the need for your help is ongoing, so please make your call tonight. Don't put it off. Make it really easy and charge your pledge to any major credit card. Oh, I hear the phone's ringing over there. Come on, leave it on. The time has passed to leave 13's future in the hands of the other guy. The station now needs us all. On this night, when Broadway plays Washington, use your phone to play your part for 13. You'll be in the company of some of Broadway's greatest.
We are one happy family, a brotherhood, a symphony.
Right, Betty?
Right. And why support Channel 13? Well,
I think it is a privilege to be able to sit at home and watch
the kind of programs you can sing about.
Armadillas, clever caterpillars, reproductions of the Cyclops, retina, crystal blowing, automatic sewing, Venus on a shell, and other works of art.
If you are not yet a contributor to the station,
I hope I can convince you.
In these days of dwindling federal funding,
to make a small effort,
on behalf of Channel 13.
Call the number on your screen and give generously to this station.
The evening won't be complete without you.
$5, $10, a basic membership of $35, $500, whatever. The two highest pledges of this weekend of tomorrow, ending Monday, will get our shooting script from Annie, autographed by all the stars. Don't forget that. And don't forget the programming on 13. That's why we're here. We need your help. Get the phones ringing. You can call throughout the program. Don't forget it.
Sends an invoice to all viewers who call and make a pledge, but if you prefer, you can mail your check tonight to 13. Use this special address, 13, Box 1313A, New York 10101. Remember to put the A following Box 1313. And thank you. Day one of a three-day weekend of tomorrow. You're building our tomorrows with your calls tonight.
Major funding for Kennedy Center tonight was provided by the Shell Companies Foundation, supporting the arts, education, and other charities. Additional funding was provided by the Program Fund of the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by this and other public television stations.
On you to join us as we wait live in the studio on this special three-day weekend of tomorrow. During this weekend, the Hollywood community, the producers and stars of Annie, and thousands of loyal tri-state area viewers determine the fortunes of 13. Don't let them down. Join in now. After all, 13's secure financial future is our good fortune. Now here live to welcome you is one of 13's most generous friends, actor Darren McGavin.
Hey, you know what I like particularly in that last act was a chance to see some of the new faces on Broadway do their stuff. Boy, they're terrific. They give real hope that the special tradition of the American musical will not only continue, but will develop in exciting new directions. That's the kind of hope that your phone call and pledge will give 13 right now. 13 needs a lot of new faces behind the scenes if it is to keep up its tradition of fine programs and develop new exciting ones. And if you're one of the regular members who star for 13, how about an encore tonight? A little extra would be greatly appreciated. But most of all, I'm talking to the many of you who have never called with a pledge or sent 13 a check. You've allowed your neighbors to pay your way. Now, if you've got the good sense and the good taste to be watching tonight, I don't believe that's your style. So come on, make your pledge for any amount you can afford. Right now, 13 is fighting to preserve its premium quality program. And if you watch, you should care enough to pledge some dollar amount. What you give to this nonprofit station is tax deductible to the fullest extent allowed by law, but you're not giving to a charity. You're giving to help pay the bills for a service you enjoy and that this community really needs. At the base of it all, we're talking survival. If you can afford the $35 membership fee, you'll be smart to pledge that amount now, because all pledges of $35 or more means a year's subscription to the Dial. If you've ever seen it, you know that it is not only lovely to look at, but it's filled with unusual insight, sometimes funny, always interesting, into the world behind the public television screen. And if you can't afford that amount, and many of 13 viewers can't, give what you can't afford. You know, there are some who still insist on calling this an elite station for the rich, as if good programs could only be enjoyed by people who earn a lot of money. Can you afford a $12 pledge? 12 bucks. I mean, that's a dollar a month for the shows you like here. Well, then call. Every single dollar helps, and the only thing that really hurts the future of this station is viewer silence. You choose the amount, but please choose to give something tonight. It's only fitting that this great Broadway showcase should highlight this first night of 13's three-day weekend of tomorrows. Unless you've been hiding out somewhere, you've heard that Hollywood's biggest musical in years is about to have its world premiere at Radio City Music Hall. Naturally, I'm talking about the movie version of the phenomenal hit, Annie. The producers refer to Annie as the movie of tomorrow's, and thanks to their generosity, and Ray Stark and Phil Feldman and all the rest of them, the premiere of Annie will help brighten 13's tomorrow. All the stars, including Carol Burnett, Albert Finney, and that wonderful, astonishing director, John Huston, are scheduled to be present Monday for the big premiere dedicated to 13. Well, you can share in the excitement right here on Monday night at 8 when 13 presents Annie's debut. Monday will be Annie's debut, but it will be the final day of this special weekend of tomorrow. 13 set aside this time to emphasize the involvement of our volunteer community, from Hollywood producer Ray Stark to the members of the Yaphank High School Band who will be playing at the premiere. And that's why we're knocking on your screen and asking you to participate with your pledge. Be part of the community that not only benefits from the premiere, but helps to make it a great tomorrow.
Hey, Tom, the Roper survey's just come in.
Oh, you mean December 81, Brad?
That's right, Tom. And it says more people say public television's more interesting than the commercial stuff.
Well, now that's interesting.
And it's more educational.
Yeah, I figure.
Maybe had less variety, but almost no bad taste.
Nah.
Of course, it's less relaxing.
Too challenging, huh?
Yeah, but they say public television's getting better.
Oh, you mean commercials getting worse.
And they say public TV's more informative and more important.
I know. That's what they say.
Yeah, more people say that commercial TV's all the same, that it's too simple-minded.
Oh, yeah, well, more say that the commercial stuff's more fun.
Well, that's true.
And that public television's more serious.
Well, of course. But they also say that it's more imaginative and more stimulating.
Well, Brad, if more people say that public TV is more interesting, educational, tasteful, getting better, more informative, important, serious, imaginative, and stimulating, then why isn't it rich?
I don't know, Tom. I guess talk is cheap.
You know, I find that survey fascinating. Although we've been friends across the screen for many, many years on many different networks, I find that most people today believe that the quality of most of television is declining and has been for some time. But in large numbers, they also believe that the quality of programs we see here on 13 is improving. Well, that certainly explains why more people than ever are watching the station. It does not, however, explain why 13 needs money. Well, frankly, television production is expensive. And since it is possible to watch 13 without being sent a bill or being told to buy a product, many of our viewers are convinced someone else has paid for it all and will continue to do so. Now, the job now is too big for people to leave it up to someone else. Inflation. Government cutbacks have made that clear. More than anything else, I hope this break makes it clear to you that you've got to stand up and be counted. So let's join Donna Drews and see how many have done just that so far this weekend. Donna?
Darren, 825 people have called so far during this first day of our weekend of tomorrow. $23,574 so far. But I'm a little concerned. I'm a little depressed. The phones are not ringing. Our volunteers are over here looking around. Okay, thanks. We needed that. What about the rest of the phones? These folks have been sitting here patiently all night. I know we always say this. They're always waiting for your call. They'll always be waiting for your call. It's always going to be true. Because the support of public television from the community, and that means all of you out there, is an ongoing process. It doesn't stop at any point, because public television is a community idea. It needs community support. Support like we have from some of these folks. Paul Hamrock from Woodside, New York. Carly Billing from Sag Harbor, Long Island. John Mannix from Wilton, Connecticut. Gladys Hort from Manhasset, New York. You see, we have a broad base of support all around the community. What about those of you out there in New Jersey? What about those of you who say, well, all I can afford is $5, maybe $6? That's fine. We need any amount. Our basic membership is $35, but whether it's $5, $35, $350, the sky's the limit. Whether it's $7.50 whether it's the leftovers that you have from the groceries this week, you think you can spare it? Whatever you think 13 is worth to you, that's what we need to get. We need to get these phones ringing, because ringing phones mean that you, the community, is behind public television. And we've talked a lot about this benefit for Channel 13 that's happening Monday, the Annie debut. Thousands of people volunteered their time, did a lot of work, put a lot of energy behind it. And it's for your benefit, because you are public television. Sure, we're in a studio here. This is the place where we live. But we don't live anywhere without you, the public. And that's the truth. That's not just a slogan, it's the truth. Because public television is an experiment. It's an ongoing experiment. It's been going on for 20 years. But things are getting a little tough. Federal withdrawal of funds means the public has to become more active. So the people that Darren's been talking about, the people out there, the 9 out of 10 who don't support public television, are probably the same 9 out of 10 who say, I like public television, it's important. Okay, folks, you know what we're on here. We're on the honor system. We don't send you a bill every month. We say, look, we know you're out there. We know you're a classy audience, and we know you're going to support us eventually. But we'd rather have it be now, okay? Darren?
Of course your call helps the station. But since I love Broadway musicals, I'm particularly hopeful all of you fellow fans will call tonight and pledge. And that way, 13 will be encouraged to present more programs on the Broadway musical. These few minutes this weekend don't add up to a lot of time, considering the size of the job we've got to do. But if we all get together, we can really do it. I mean, really. Consider the job 13 does for us, and you'll pick up your phone and make your pledge. Not a day goes by that it isn't here with something to brighten or enlighten our lives. So please, don't let this day go by without making the call that only you can make. Don't let this day go by without making the call that only you can make. I felt like a song cue, and it is. But more than anything else, it's your cue to call right now.
You know, this weekend is special in a variety of ways, Darren, and all of you out there listening. It's because it's only a 3-day pledge period that it's special. We're trying that. We're going to see how you respond to that. And you're setting the pace of support for this weekend. You're also stressing any amount that you can afford, as I keep saying, and it's really important. I can't stress that enough. Any amount you can afford, whatever 13 is worth to you, that's what we need to get. And also, we have something very special, of course, as we've been talking about, this benefit premiere, which benefits Channel 13. Now, the idea of this premiere is not to get you to say, well, they're giving money, so I guess I don't have to. The idea of Ray Stark, the producer of Annie, and all the other volunteers who have made this premiere of Annie possible on Monday night is to inspire you to support Channel 13, right? To let you know you're not the only one out there who enjoys 13 and is willing to support it. Thousands and thousands, millions of you out there are watching. We know that from the surveys. Now, what about the millions of phone calls that we're not getting? It's time, don't you think?
And another way to help 13 during this special weekend of tomorrow is to simply mail a check. Please use this special address, 13 Box 1313A, New York 10101. And be sure to put a letter A following Box 1313. Thank you. The weekend of tomorrow, 3 special days for you to help 13 build many special tomorrows.
Something in your eye. Now the show leaves Washington and is live here in New York at 13 as we celebrate our special 3-day weekend of tomorrow. This is a weekend of community-wide support, joined by the makers and stars of a brand new movie musical, Annie, premiering at Radio City Music Hall on Monday, all for the benefit of 13. Join the 13 community now. You set the pace. You're in charge. Right now, we're delighted that this 2-time Tony Award nominee is here, fresh from her performance in 42nd Street, where they're probably still cheering her at the Majestic. Please welcome Millicent Martin.
If you're just joining us, 13 will be the beneficiary of the world premiere showing of the movie Annie this Monday night at Radio City Music Hall. It's great news for this station and all of us who live in this community. It's an example of the volunteerism that has come Fourth, if public television is to survive the dramatic cuts in funding supports from the federal government and inflation. They're calling Annie the movie of tomorrow. And 13 calls this weekend the weekend of tomorrow. Because what you do right now will truly determine this station's future. If you're new to this form of financial support, or even if you've already given this year, please decide to make your call now. Every call of any amount is a vote for 13 to be around for many tomorrows. You can also decide to be silent and pledge nothing. But it's only fair to let you know at this stage of the game, public silence can kill public television. Of course, I'm hoping a lot of you will decide now is the time to become a member of 13 and pledge $35 or more. You'll receive for 1 year, every single month, the Dial program guide and magazine. And if you don't think the Dial is a good notch above other such magazines, you're forgetting how good your 13 is compared to so many other channels. I want to stress that the station is asking you to select any dollar amount, and it means any, to help preserve the best premium it offers to all of us, the great shows we see here. If you are a member, you know how enjoyable the Dial is. For instance, this month the Dial asked all members to vote for 4 movies in a list of 20. The winners will be shown this summer when Cinema 13 presents Viewer's Choice. Members were supposed to get their votes in by May 10th, but 13 wants to convince you all that it's serious when it says any amount counts. So why not get out a pencil and any major credit card, write down the 4 numbers you wish to see when we present the movie list, and you'll hear the 4 winners announced here Monday when the grand finale of 13's Weekend of Tomorrow is celebrated with a special program highlighting the premiere of Annie. It's called Annie's Debut, and it's here Monday night at 8. And when you do call with your vote, how about giving 13 the dollars you won't have to spend to see a movie on those nights? Because the movie you really want to see will be right here on your own 13. Believe me, 13 can use at $5, $10, $15, or $20. Oh, you say revival houses charge less. Well, 13 can use that for $8, $12, or $16. I think you've got the message. Now, here's Donna Drews with the movie titles and some figures that certainly will help decide if the sun will come up tomorrow for 13. Donna?
Thank you, Millicent. A lot of people have called in. As a matter of fact, 1,083 people have called in so far in this 3-day drive. 29,664 is the dollar total. But do you hear that in the background? It's silent. Not a single phone is ringing. Do you like the sound of that? Ah, thanks. I like that a lot better. I don't know about you. Okay, what about the rest? Everybody's over there laughing, saying, okay, okay. What about the telephones? Are they ringing? They're not ringing. Well, okay, you probably think, why do they have to have these on-air campaigns? You know, I'm really tired. I'm not going to call. Well, it's up to you. We're on the honor system. And if you don't call, public television goes down the tube, if you'll pardon the pun. And that's serious. Now, let me give you some more information. Here's the list of the 20 films eligible for our Viewer's Choice 13 Film Festival. Now, the top 4 will be shown, and the winners will be announced this Monday when 13 celebrates the world premiere of Hollywood's latest major release on Annie's debut Monday night at 8. Your pencils ready? Okay. Now, remember, choose no more than 4 films. Just write down the number of the film. Now, first, you can see Arthur Miller's All My Sons with Burt Lancaster and Edward G. Robinson, or find out what those Hubbards were like before the Little Foxes and choose Lillian Hellman's Another Part of the Forest. Or there's Charles Boyer and Margaret Sullivan in the definitive version of Backstreet, and there's the big Ray Milland thriller, The Big Clock. Now, if being scared is your scene, choose Cape Fear. That's a scary one. Robert Mitchum will do the rest. And there's Billy Wilder's post-war comedy with Marlene Dietrich, A Foreign Affair. Or you can see the handsome Gary Cooper in The General Died at Dawn. George Raft and Edward Arnold star in Dashiell Hammett's The Glass Key. Or choose Preston Sturges' classic comedy, Hail the Conquering Hero. Or see Mae West conquer Cary Grant in I'm No Angel. And there's Ronald Colman's shining performance in Rudyard Kipling's The Light That Failed. Or how about little Shirley Temple and Little Miss Marker? Jeanette MacDonald and Marie Chevalier again, and music by Rodgers and Hart star in Love Me Tonight. Or there's Ray Milland in Fritz Lang's Ministry of Fear, based on a Graham Greene story.
Little Deanna Durbin is the minority, definitely, in 100 Men and a Girl. And there's the comedy Our Hearts Were Young and Gay. Claudette Colbert stars in Preston Sturges' screwball comedy, The Palm Beach Story. Or you can vote for Tracy and Hepburn in The State of the Union. Rosalind Russell is the liberated lady in Take a Letter, Darling. Or you can invite 13 to show you that haunting thriller, The Uninvited. Well, that's the list. And if you're a member and didn't send in your choice, grab your copy of the dial and let us know now. Give the numbers of your choices to the operator who takes your pledge. All viewers are invited to vote, but to do so, and here's the catch, you must vote to give 13 some dollars to keep the shows and movies coming. That's the most important thing you can do for our tomorrows on this special three-day weekend. And now, back to you, Millicent.
This special three-day weekend without your phone call is 3 days of interrupted programs to no purpose. Believe me, this station thinks long and hard about each and every program it airs and every pledge break it plans. In fact, a survey showed that 92% of the viewers understood that on-air fundraising was necessary. If you're among that 92%, where are you right now when this station needs you so badly? As viewers, we should all use this weekend to pledge a little or a lot. The only thing that hurts is silence. Oh, good, there's no more silence. A pledge tonight not only helps 13, it could encourage others to be as imaginative and generous to public television as Annie producer Ray Stark, who has offered opening nights of Annie to local public television stations throughout the country. Before we return to the conclusion of Broadway Plays Washington, let me remind you that tomorrow night is a must-see night on 13 as well. At 8, there's an encore presentation of City Spaces, the fascinating Nova special on urban design and how it affects us all. At 9:05, don't miss the concluding episode on Masterpiece Theatre of Love in a Cold Climate. And remember, the stars of Brideshead Revisited, Anthony Andrews, Jeremy Irons, and Diana Quick, will do their part for 13 during the break. At 10:15, by viewer request, it's a special extra showing of the fabulous concert with Count Basie and Tony Bennett, and it's all here tomorrow. The real focus of this weekend is those many tomorrows, that every single call helps the shore for 13. The station was born on hope and has survived its share of crisis for 20 years. Not only has 13 survived, it has improved and grown. The benefit premiere of Annie may sing of hope for tomorrow, but you actually give 13 solid help for its future with every call and every pledge. It's true, today is a time of financial crisis for 13, but you can bet your bottom dollar the dollars you pledge tonight will keep the show shining here. There's very little time. Tonight is almost over. Please do it now. Thank you.
We'll be back to Broadway Plays Washington in a minute. And coming up soon, Alexis Smith in this next act, all the stars from Sophisticated Ladies, and all the little girls who've played Annie since its inception. That's going to be fun. And speaking of Annie, something else that's going to be fun, we've mentioned it before. If you haven't heard, the debut of the film of Annie, the world premiere, will be here at Radio City Music Hall Monday night, and it will benefit Channel 13. All the proceeds from that premiere will benefit Channel 13. That's pretty terrific. And we'll be here Monday night at 8 o'clock from 8 to 9 with a special program about that premiere, special interviews, features, and little film clips from Annie. So I think you'll enjoy that. I'll be here. I hope you'll be here. Oh, by the way, during this three-day weekend, for those of you, the two of you who give the highest pledge, we have a surprise for you. This is the shooting script from that film of Annie. And it has all of the autographs of the stars, from Albert Finney up here, Aileen Quinn, who plays Annie, down to Tim Curry here on the bottom. And these two scripts, there are two of them here, I promise. Here's the other one. These will be given for the two highest pledges during this three-day weekend of tomorrow. So if you're interested in this, and it will be a collector's item, call now, give the highest pledge you can think of, and then see what happens, okay? But whatever amount you can afford to pledge, we need to hear from you. Boy, are these phones silent, and boy, does that scare us. Call us.
13 will send an invoice to all viewers who call and make a pledge, but if you prefer, you can mail your check tonight to 13. So please use this special address. It's 13, Box 1313A, New York 10101. And remember to put the A following Box 1313. Thank you. Day one of 13's special three-day weekend of tomorrow. Your call tonight is the start of our bright tomorrows.
We'll be right back with Pearl Bailey, Melba Moore, Cheetah Rivera, and a grand finale as Broadway plays Washington on Kennedy Center tonight.
Weekend of Tomorrow continues with the backing of Hollywood stars and producers of Annie joining hands with all of us in the viewing community, and all for the benefit of our 13. Have you called in your support yet? There's very little time left. Right now, come live to the 13 studios, where after two performances today in 42nd Street, a twice-nominated Tony Award star awaits you. Once again, here's Millicent Martin.
When it comes to shows, the big question many people ask is, what makes a hit show? Does anyone really know? One rather smart response is easy. The best way to get a hit is to produce a show the public flocks to see. Well, that sounds simplistic enough, naturally. If everyone wants to see it, you've got a money-making hit on your hands. That goes without saying, right? No, wrong. Very wrong when it comes to 13. This year, more people are flocking to see 13 than at any other time in its history. And yet, when given the opportunity on nights like this to applaud the station, only one viewer in 10 calls in with a pledge. If anyone had to rate 13 this year, they would say it was a season of great hits and superb quality. In fact, many are calling this public television's finest season ever. With those shows and its larger than ever audience, 13 should be a great money-making smash success. And it isn't. Its problem is, well, let's put it this way. Say you're a Broadway producer with a hit playing to standing room only audiences night after night. But say only 10% of the audience pays anything to get in. The other 90% are laughing in the right places, crying at the right moments, learning and loving it all, but not giving anything to help meet your costs of running the show. Well, things aren't just going to work out, and you're going to be posting a closing notice in no time. Well, 13 isn't posting a closing notice, but it's dedicating this special three-day weekend to giving you notice that now is the time to show you care. Please don't be misled by the easy access to 13. It needs your support to remain on the dial. Pledge what you can afford. 20 years ago, this station was founded on the conviction that the public wanted an alternative choice to regular television programming. Against all odds, 13 was established, and it has endured some hard knocks. This weekend of tomorrow is a direct appeal to each and every viewer to contribute to a future filled with quality hits. They're in the planning stages right now, but without a call from each one of us, that future will never materialize. Possibly the biggest world premiere seen here in 20 years has been dedicated to our community's 13 by the producer of Annie. Now, isn't that a cue for each of us, every one of you in this community who enjoys 13, to show your support for this station plagued by federal funding cutbacks and inflation? Be an angel. To make it even easier, you can charge your pledge to any major credit card. Here's Donna with a report on how many are joining our casting call this weekend.
1,237, Millicent. That's how many calls we had tonight, for a grand total of $33,568 in the 13 coffers, thanks to those of you who have called and pledged your financial support to 13 in varying amounts, from $5. We've had $100 pledges. Our basic membership is $35. But please keep these phones ringing. If you've given up because the phones have been busy, please don't do that to us. We have some phones available now, so please call us now and give your support. There's not much time left tonight, and we only have 2 days left in this weekend of tomorrows to ensure our tomorrows with your support. You know, this has been the best season, according to the ratings, that public television has ever had. Series like Life on Earth, Creativity with Bill Moyers, Ireland, which you just saw earlier tonight, and the finest series that's ever been filmed for television, again, according to the critics and according to viewership, Brideshead Revisited. All of these programs have been on just in one season. And the polls show that more people are watching public television than ever before. But how many people are pledging to public television? 1 in 10, same as before. It's kind of discouraging, you know, because we know that these are good series and we know you're watching them. But we need to hear from you to continue this kind of quality programming, because that's what public television is here for, quality programming. Well, speaking of Brideshead Revisited, by the way, the stars of Brideshead Revisited, Anthony Andrews, Jeremy Irons, Diana Quick, will be here with some words of encouragement for us tomorrow night. But the best words of encouragement we need to hear are from you, your words saying, I pledge this much for public television. Right? It's time. Millicent?
Get in on the excitement of the weekend of tomorrow, tonight, by making your pledge right now. It can't be said too often that every single dollar represents your endorsement of this station and its programs. You are the public in public television. The moment you do your part is right now. When you endorse 13 with a pledge, you're giving us a green light to go ahead. If the Hollywood cast cares, isn't it time for you to express your concern as well? Other people who care are here now for one reason only, to take your call. Please keep them busy with your pledge.
I think that it's absolutely super that PBS is going to benefit from this film.
Well, I couldn't be happier myself. I think it's one of the worthiest openings that I've ever heard about.
Well, I think it's fantastic. I think PBS is a marvelous enterprise.
I think that's wonderful. A lot of money they're going to make, aren't they? A couple of million.
Public television is very important for documentary-type situations.
If you want to see a good movie, you turn on PBS.
They're nearly always shown on PBS. It has the taste to share them.
A lot of the shows that are on it come from my own country. And so I see... I've caught up while being here with some of the episodes of things that I've missed in England.
I like what they do on the arts, on the paintings, on the dance, on the opera.
Public television is a very important thing.
It's good for your soul.
You can hear Pavarotti and the whole gang and Joan Sutherland, PBS. Bravo.
I think it's great.
Send money to public television today.
And I hope everybody comes to see me and Annie.
What a cast to have as backers of our station. You can see them all Monday night at 8 o'clock on Annie's debut, the rousing finale to this weekend of tomorrow. The finale of Broadway Plays Washington is here in seconds, and no one wants to miss Miss Pearlie May doing Hello Dolly. But don't go away and watch until you've taken a minute or so to call and give something to 13, please. Dial this number now and say, Hello 13, I want to make a pledge. Your call is the only way you can keep 13 a long-running hit. And doesn't it deserve it after 20 years of community service and quality programming for all of us who live and work in this area? Just imagine those 20 years without 13 on the dial. Every silent phone makes such a disaster seem possible. Every ringing phone, every pledge, every dollar keeps the curtain up, and that's where it belongs. And that's where it will stay, thanks to your call now.
How much should you pledge? You're the only one that can answer that question. It's up to you. We're not even setting a dollar amount this time. We're not setting a number amount. We figure in a three-day weekend, it's up to you to set the pace of how much you can support Channel 13 in this period of time. So please, any amount you can afford to give. Our basic membership, $35, and with that you receive the Dial magazine every month, full of interesting articles and, of course, our schedule. But our programming is the best premium we have to offer. No question about that. You're watching in record numbers. It's time to support us in record numbers. And for those of you who support us in record numbers to the tune of the highest two pledges of this three-day weekend, we've got the film script of Annie right here, autographed by all the stars of Annie, from Aileen Quinn, who plays Annie, and she's drawn a little picture. It's so cute. Down here to Tim Curry, Carol Burnett, everybody in between. So please, if you're interested in being very generous and getting a collector's item, call now and pledge as much as you can afford. Maybe you'll be the winner of one of these two Annie scripts.
Remember, though, it's the programs that should inspire you to call in. Inspire us to keep them coming, okay? Thank you.
This weekend is so special, we even have a special address for you to use if you prefer to mail a check to 13. And here it is, 13 Box 1313A, New York, New York, 10101. Please be sure to add that letter A after Box 1313. Thank you. 3 days to build many tomorrows. Add your strength before this first day flies by. Comedy is next on To the Manor Born, followed by Michael Palin with Dick Cavett. If you're a Broadway musical comedy fan, right now is the moment to do your job in this weekend of tomorrow. It's 13's 3-day opportunity to you to give us the helping hand we must have to surmount the loss of dollars in federal funding support. Monday night, we're getting a helping hand when the world premiere of Annie, the movie of tomorrow, holds a grand Hollywood-style all-star premiere at Radio City Music Hall as a special benefit for 13. That's the spirit we need from each of you who enjoy the station. We'll share with you the premiere excitement right here when we present Annie's debut Monday night at 8. But now it's time to share with us the job of keeping 13 the unique station it is for you. Feel free to pledge any dollar amount you can afford. Remember, you can use a credit card to charge all pledges of $10 or more. Every pledge of $35 or more makes you a member of 13, and you'll enjoy receiving and reading every month the For Members Only program guide and magazine, The Dial. And if you call right now and pledge $40 or more, we'll say thank you with the brand new album of the soundtrack from the motion picture Annie. All your favorite songs from the show are on it, with some new numbers written for the film. The biggest premium of all, of course, are the shows you enjoy here. Your dollars are needed to assure their tomorrows, and tonight is the time to call. Who better to convince you of how important you are to our future than this great star who recently triumphed as Peter Pan on Broadway? She made this message as a friend and a friend of 13 and resident of this community who knows what our viewers do tonight truly decides our tomorrows.
Hi, I'm Sandy Duncan, and I'm here to ask you to call Channel 13 and give your support for programs like the one we've been watching. I've been involved in show business for quite a while, and I've learned that it helps to have talent, and it helps to have looks, but most of all, you've got to have your health. Now, public television has lots of talent, and it airs a lot of good-looking shows, but the state of its health depends on its viewers, you and me. Our membership dollars are its main strength. Please call the number on your screen now and make a pledge to keep Channel 13 thriving. A basic membership for an entire year comes to only pennies a day, and it includes a subscription to the station's monthly program guide. If your budget can spare a few dollars more, 13 will send you a special token of thanks. Any amount you can manage is important to all of us.
Did you ever stop to think about what makes you laugh? Or just 1 minute, something could happen, and all of a sudden you'll be doing it. Laughing, or applauding, or crying. What will you be doing in the next minute?
Channel 13, may I help you?
Now, we don't promise that you'll be laughing or applauding or crying every minute you watch Channel 13. But if you call in the next minute, you'll be supporting countless minutes of the stuff laughter and applause and tears are made of. Are you a member of 13? What are you doing in the next minute?
Now, there are other important ways that your dollar can do extra duty. For instance, many corporations are encouraged by your support to put their money into programs you've helped get started. When that happens, membership dollars are freed up to develop new ideas and new programs. That's basically how public television grows. Every pledge is a shot in the arm that helps keep this station healthy. And good health means more fine programs like the one we're watching. Won't you call now and give Channel 13 a shot in the arm? When public television was born, it was a pretty weak baby. Very few channels, terrible reception. Most TV sets at the time couldn't even pick up the UHF signals, which were assigned to many public stations. But thanks to all of us chipping in, public television has grown to be strong and healthy. It's brought the great wide world of science into our homes. It's taken us traveling to strange and distant places. Its witty and wonderful kids' shows have revolutionized education. And how about the ballet? Thanks to the supporters of public television, you can live in the smallest town in the prairie and still have the best seats in the house at Lincoln Center. You know, as a matter of fact, one orchestra seat to one evening's performance costs about the same as a membership in Channel 13. But your pledge puts you in front row seats for an entire year of top performances. Public television has grown from its fragile start to become the world's largest stage for every kind of entertainment and our most important forum for public affairs. And that's because we've all cared enough to give our help. If you're not already a Channel 13 member, join us now. Let's ensure the ongoing health of public television. Please call now and give it your shot in the arm.
Musical comedy that's starring tonight for 13, it's Your Phone Call. In seconds, this first day of our three-day weekend of tomorrow will be over. The time is short and the task is enormous. Viewer support must increase if 13's to remain the source of quality programs that you now enjoy. Any amount helps us fight inflation and the cutbacks in federal funding support. Every silent phone hurts us and threatens our future. So come on, end this day knowing you've done your part to build our tomorrows. After all, you're the person who will enjoy the shows. A final reminder, any pledge of $40 or more entitles you to ask for the brand new stereo LP of the motion picture soundtrack from Annie. It's a perfect thank you for your support during this important weekend of tomorrow. Please make your pledge now and then be here Monday at 8 as one of the cast of viewers who's helped 13's tomorrows come true.
She always was everyone's favorite orphan, and now she's gone Hollywood. It's Annie's debut, and she's sharing it with us. Even as she's world premiering at Radio City, we'll be partying with the very stars who turned her into the biggest movie musical ever. How did they do it? You'll find out, and you'll even see some of Annie's magic. Chock full of surprises, you can bet your bottom dollar that Annie's debut is the event of tomorrow. We've been singing a lot about tomorrow ourselves lately, but with Annie's debut on 13, we'll all be singing together.
That's Monday at 8 on member-supported 13. You can use your credit card and make your pledge at 800-358-9150 throughout to the Manor Born. Please make note of the phone number. Again, 800-358-9150. And now enjoy the show and remember to stay for Michael Palin of Monty Python when he visits Cabot. That's right after to the Manor Born. This weekend is so special, we even have a special address for you to use if you prefer to mail a check to 13. And here it is. 13 Box 1313A, New York, New York 10101. Please be sure to add that letter A after Box 1313. And thank you. Just 3 days to build many tomorrows. Have you added your strength to 13? ¶¶